the involvement of members of the community in information gathering, and the development of harmonious interpersonal relationships with the people and their leaders, while showing respect for their religious and cultural beliefs, should pave the way for peace in potential areas of conflict. We must strive to modernize our available technology, weaponry, and skill training abilities. Civil-military operations must be updated to focus on the needs of a particular group of people, in keeping with the Army's objectives, in accordance with the Army Transformation Roadmap. Our officers and each and every soldier should always try to find ways to better themselves and work cohesively in the service of the people through education, training programs, innovations, research and development, and people-centered activities. To ensure the free flowing of ideas, the betterment of the Philippine Army as a whole, the establishment of an operation research center will be pursued to harness the intellect and motivate every trooper to bring out his best to come up with guidelines, techniques, and innovations on how to better our present setup and manner of doing things. I will carry on with the programs of the commanders before me and sustain the gains that the Philippine Army has achieved to date. In keeping with President Duterte's call for transparency, let us justify with logical and sound reasons our goals and match them with our available resources to make our plans feasible. John Maxwell said, "Leaders become great not because of their power, but because of their ability to empower others." Let me remind each and every one of us in the service that Section 1 of Article 11 of the 1987 Constitution, entitled Accountability of Public Officers, states, "Public office is a public trust. Public officers and employees must, and at all times, be accountable to the people. Serve them with utmost responsibility, integrity, loyalty, and efficiency. Act with patriotism and justice, and lead modest lives." To our outgoing commander, Lieutenant General Miranda, sir, as you leave the service, allow me to thank you on behalf of your troops for a very job well done. Rest assured that we will build on the foundations that you have laid, and collectively, we will strive to achieve new heights. We wish you all the best in the next chapter of your life. The leadership of the Philippine Army under my watch shall work in unison, on new thrusts which have come to my attention after staying in Marawi from May 23 to October 3, 2017. 1, maximizing troop effort by enabling our soldiers to focus on their job without additional burdens in mind. We will look into programs that alleviate the worries of our soldiers, which are no different from other Filipinos: shelter, education, healthcare, and livelihood for their families. 2, strengthening our CMO units' stakeholders' participation and lead them towards selfless private and government partnerships which empower people-centered volunteerism that will win the hearts and minds of the people while serving communities. The Army will continue to lead and assist in the rebuilding of Marawi City, just like what we did in Barangay Bito Buadi, Itoa, of the said city last October 2, where government agencies, namely the Department of National Defense, the General Headquarters, and 3 units of the Philippine Army, the 1st Infantry Tabak Division, 54th Engineer Brigade, and the Mechanized Infantry Division, came together in the spirit of Bayanihan with volunteers from the private sector, not asking for any favor from the government. The Chinese Filipino Business Club Incorporated, headed by its president, Mr. Willie Chuwayap, and the ever-supportive Tarlac Heritage Foundation, co-founded by Ma'am Isabel and Isa Suntay, to build a green, self-sustained community measuring 1.2 hectares at said barangay, which will be home to 50 families of the Marawi conflict in what is called an immediate shelter and accommodation for the internally displaced peoples, or IDPs. It is designed by Filipinos and crafted by the soldiers and kapgus of the Philippine Army. The administration of President Duterte, as represented by the above said government agencies, and these generous and selfless donors have given the IDPs of Marawi City the dignity and respect that they especially need during this critical period in terms of their lives, to enable them to return back to normalcy. This showcases the ingenuity and talent of our soldiers in nation building, a Filipino version of the pop-up tent. 3, we must work towards encouraging a new role for reservists who play the part in helping us attain our security goals in Marawi. Reservists, ROTC cadets, and even CAT trainees in high schools may all be put to good use for the benefit of our national security goals. 4, making the most of military cooperation with foreign counterparts to boost and upgrade our strategic and tactical gains while at the same time enabling us to better our capabilities. As the newly designated Commanding General of the Philippine Army's 87th Strong Soldiers, I give each and every one of you my wholehearted support and absolute dedication to duty. Your welfare and well-being shall be my primary concern. Together, let us harness one another's potentials toward the realization of a dynamic Philippine Army, one that is morally and spiritually upright and truly cares while being of service to its people. Let our resourcefulness, trailblazing, and creativity be one that our citizens will admire. May the spirit of Bayanihan see us through in all our undertakings, for together our 80,007 deeds can account for a whole lot of good. Finally, may I ask everyone to always offer a prayer for the heroes of Marawi and their loved ones, being counted with each and every one of you who were and still are in Marawi, the killed in action, the wounded in action, and the troops still fighting it out in the main battle area, is a privilege and an honor for me. May the memories of all the heroes in Marawi live on in the hearts and minds of the Filipino people, whom they unstintingly serve in the line of duty to ensure that peace reigns in this country. Maraming salamat po. Mabuhay ang humpong katiyan ng Pilipinas. Mabuhay ang Republika ng Pilipinas. Ano po na?